Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, think you're smart, as they say, smarter than a high schooler? A Providence student group is calling a mandatory test known as the NECAP unfair. And the group asked 50 adults to take a mock version of the test. Well, it looks like 60% of those grown-ups failed, at least the math portion of the test. The latest real test scores show that many members of the class of 2014 are at risk of not graduating next year. 40% high school juniors scored in the lowest performing category in math on the NECAP test. State Education Commissioner Deborah Geist is defending the testing requirement. I was never a good person to test.
Never.
I really wasn't.
This is hard because, like you just mentioned, people that aren't good test takers, which a lot of people were.
They're just not.
I mean, what was that like for you going through school?
Going through school, I could do the book stuff, you know, without much problem. There was a summer school thing in there a couple of times, but who's counting? Yeah, you know what happens. But when it came to sit down to actually do, like, a test, mm-hmm. as you're sitting there.
Multiple choice.
You get
the,
yeah, absolutely. As much as you think you know the stuff and as much as you think you study, the second that you're sitting down there and looking at it, that was when I would freak out and...
Panic mode,
yeah.
That's when I realized I had ADD,
yeah.
because I couldn't do it in that amount of time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I also forgot my calculator. I remember on the day of, like, forgets the calculator. Sorry, Mom. So, you know, I was a terrible test taker. I did awfully. And I even took those PSAT test preps, you know,
right,
when you have to go on Sundays.
Yeah.
I did a tad bit better, but no, I didn't do well on those practice runs either. I don't know. I personally don't think it's a telling sign that you can go to your next higher education, college, mm-hmm. whatever it may be, and do better just because of these tests. Like I was saying to you guys earlier, like, they should prepare you more for the next step of your,
absolutely.
Of your life.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I just think it's difficult because now with the senior projects, mm-hmm. or these tests where kids are pressured enough in school to get everything done. And let's face it, colleges are looking at grades,
right.
as a whole. Maybe not so much as the SATs. They didn't weigh as heavily now as they did a couple years ago. But putting that much more added pressure on, mm-hmm. these students is so tough. Can you imagine going into a test being like, well, my entire post-high school career depends on
this. No matter how
this
much you did well.
These few answers.
Yeah.
Plus, apparently, we don't really need them as we get older because the adults that took them didn't know that information.
No, that's true.
Exactly.
And, you know, we're not saying that we want these kids to turn into wimps. I get the testing.
No.
I get how it has to be. I've talked to a lot of friends who are teachers, and they say that they're making these kids, like, test to death. That's all they're, mm-hmm. doing. The teachers actually don't have time to actually go in and teach them the lesson that they need to.
Instead of making them well-rounded.
Right.
Like, hey,
everything
why don't you volunteer
is a test.
And do this,
a test.
And sport, and do this,
yes.
and arts, and that's the reason why you go to the next stage.
Right. I'm all
and
for,
figure out what you want to do.
I'm all for challenging them and maybe having, this should just be more frequent.
Mm-hmm.
Should they maybe just take the test a couple times throughout the year,
mm-hmm.
so that way they're consistently keeping up with the knowledge that they need that are on these tests? But if all of a sudden, you know, the end of the year starts coming around and now, hey, you can't cross that stage unless you get a good grade on this or unless your senior project's done, I can't tell you how many kids I've seen stress out about that senior project.
And that's another thing, that whole senior project thing. I never had that when I was in high school.
No.
I never had to do that. I guess that's something new and something that they say if you don't do it and you don't do well on it, you're, mm-hmm. not graduating. So it's another burden. Like
the concept is good
because it's
almost like your first internship,
mm-hmm.
in a
right.
way, because you're picking someone's brain to base your project on, but having it weigh so heavily is, I don't know.
And to that point, like, make sure it gets into their heads. Like, you want to make sure you have an internship or, mm-hmm. try out different careers.
Yes.
Like, that's what they should be talking about in high school.
That's the thing that no one's getting prepared for, either college or the real world when they get out.
Yeah. Right.
Because it's tough.
Well, we put it out to our Facebook friends and our followers on Twitter, and here's what some are saying. Rachel Pavo says, no, some people have test anxiety and do not do well on tests.
Exactly. I am that anxiety person.
But give them a regular assignment and they will prove that they can do the work.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Dana Rich weighs in and says, absolutely not. The questions on the mock test are items the average person does not use in their day-to-day life. Educators are setting these kids up to fail.
Maybe they just need to go over the material more.
Sherry Fitzhebert says, yes, they should. Who wants their kids to be in their position? I guess meaning the adults that took the test and didn't do well. We want our kids to surpass everything we've done and do a lot better. All right, a different perspective. Mm-hmm. But then Sloppy Joe weighs in and says, no, let the teachers get back to good old-fashioned classroom teaching and stop testing the students to death.
Right.